you're welcome to stay at the ranch if you want.
Yeah, we'd love to.
Okay. Well, great. I look forward to seeing you. I'd like to get together and goof off again.
Yeah.
Just have some good old fun.
Yep.
It was the first time Michael had sat for a portrait. Japanese tycoon Hiro Saiki wanted to buy it, and they said, give us $2 million.
We're surprised. He came back and he says, well, yeah, of course I want it. So we sold it. We said, okay, it's yours.
The painting was the result of a partnership between Jackson and Strong. Brett says Michael admired his sculptures, which include this statue of John Lennon. And now he has a new, somewhat racier portrait of Michael. Strong says Jackson posed for it at his Neverland ranch.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to express my gratitude to those responsible for the American Cinema Awards. I thank David Guest, you're just fantastic. Thank you so much.
One man who wasn't up for a Grammy this year was Michael Jackson, but he did put in an appearance anyway on Tuesday morning when his record company threw a breakfast press conference for him to announce that he has now sold more than 110 million records.
The largest selling album in the history of recorded music. The two largest selling albums of the 1980s. The only album ever to produce 5 number one singles.
I'm sure it won't surprise you that I'm going to make this one short again, but I'll have to say, however, that no album sells itself. It is up to the people out there to buy it. But I especially want to thank everyone, everywhere, who helped make this award what it is. First a possibility, and now a reality.
Welcome, Michael Jackson here. He's been the main artist of the decade, and he has a tremendous following. He does good works, what we call the points of light concept, and I just wanted to bring him out here and officially welcome him to the White House once again. Glad you're here, sir. Very pleased you're here.
Of showbiz and big biz, music's magic man and the Midas mogul ran the media gauntlet to open the world's glitziest casino. That fan hysteria reminded me of 1963 when I covered the Beatles' arrival in America. Donald Trump gave Michael Jackson a personal tour of his $1.2 billion extravaganza. And we were there every step of the way. If the Taj Mahal Casino is the eighth wonder of the world, on that day it seemed the beloved Club One ranked ninth. 75,000 fans nearly swept away supermodel Elle McPherson. But they didn't stop the casino take topping $2 million for the day.
Michael at the Taj Mahal, he's my friend, he's a tremendous talent, and it's really my honor. It's a big day for me.
Ryan White's life ended Sunday morning after a 5.5-year battle with AIDS.
Jackson heard about Ryan the same way everyone else did, through TV and newspaper.
Michael wanted to get there in time to see Ryan, but we did not think he would live past midnight, so therefore we didn't think Michael could get there in time. But it ended up Ryan lived till 7 in the morning, and Michael could have made it, and Michael really felt bad because he did not attempt and try to get there.
Where are the parents now? I'm sure they're at the house. There must be at the house.
Good
Mask.
He wanted to see you. I think most people don't realize that he just didn't help Brian White. He helped so many other kids too. And that's a quality of Michael, I think, that very few people know about, because Michael doesn't seek out the publicity.
Sad news this week with the death of a teenager whose fight with AIDS touched many rock stars and the rest of America. Ryan White died this week, 5 years after contracting AIDS from a transfusion. And friends like Elton John and Michael Jackson helped support Ryan in his own campaign to promote public awareness of the disease.
AIDS victim Ryan White was remembered during funeral services this afternoon at Second Presbyterian Church on North Meridian Street.
The mourners gathered, including a host of celebrities like Elton John, Phil Donahue, Michael Jackson, and First Lady Barbara Bush.
It was Ryan who first humanitized the disease called AIDS. He allowed us to see the boy who just wanted more than anything else to be like other children. He healed a wounded spirit in a world and made it whole.
To the best of my knowledge, it happened last evening when he was rehearsing at his home, and he had some kind of little pass out, and when he woke up, he called his physician, and he took him to the hospital.
The rock star was admitted last night after complaining of chest pains. The hospital kept a tight lid on Jackson's exact ailment, saying that he was in stable condition after a night of tests. Those tests include cardiac analysis, but the hospital ruled out a heart attack. There's no word on when Jackson will be released from the hospital.
His physician, Dr. Stephen Hofflin, states that he will be undergoing several diagnostic tests today. He was admitted to St. John's to our emergency department last night at approximately 9 p.m., complaining of chest discomfort.
Fans gathered outside St. John's Hospital in Santa Monica, California, have been loyal, but have learned little about his condition.
Not a lot, just he's undergoing tests and they don't know what's wrong, so it's really worrisome to not know anything. We just don't know what to think.
One fan was arrested after going too far. A 42-year-old who uses the name Billie Jean Jackson was arrested for violating a restraining order mandating that she stay 500 feet away from the pop star. The 31-year-old singer-songwriter has been hard at work on his new album called Decade, and according to spokesman Bob Jones, Jackson was particularly distraught over the recent deaths of both his maternal grandmother and entertainer Sammy Davis Jr.
The pressure from the album, the pressure on impending engagements, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So there are a lot of pressures on him.
Michael Jackson hits called Decade may be put on hold. Sources inside the Jackson camp say the pop star has recorded so much new material that a studio album of new songs may be released instead. A spokesman for Jackson's record label will only say that something with Jackson's name on it will be released before the end of the year.
Michael Jackson's Moonwalker video game, only on the Genesis system by Sega.
Now he has teamed up with a leading video game company to devise the ultimate video game experience. And its star is Michael Jackson himself. Michael Jackson moves from music videos to both home and arcade videos with the introduction of the Sega video game Moonwalker. Jackson worked closely with Sega's Al Nilsson and was instrumental in the game's development.
Michael would go back and play the game and then call us up or talk to us and say, here are things that should be included, here's things that should be changed.
According to retailers, the shelves are loaded with these babies, but back-to-school shopping parents
are shying away from purchase because, according to one shoe industry czar, they make kids wearing them look like junior Hell's Angels.
Primetime cartoon terror is now on the rise, however, with none other than Michael Jackson giving him a boost. Jackson has written a song titled, Do the Bart, Man, and he wants to record it as a duet with Bart. Simpsons creators have given the okay, and it should be in record stores by Christmas, but if it's a week or so late, don't have a cow.
Everybody, if you can do the fine man, girl, shake your body, turn it up. You can
kick it out, man.
To the side, and you can get
it.
Everybody in the house, the fine man, girl, shake your body, if you can do the fine man.